5. Okay. So our main set, universal set, is x equal to 1 to 25. It contains 25 integers. And I want to select some two integers from x and from the set S, subject to different conditions. For the first problem, the condition is mod of a minus b is equal to 5. That is, absolute difference between these two numbers is 5. For example, if I take a is equal to 3 and b is equal to, say, 8, then mod of a minus b is 5. So I can take 3 and 8 in the set S. Okay, this is our first condition, the mod of a minus b is equal to 5. Remember this condition. But if I take a is equal to 2 and b is equal to, say, 9, then mod of a minus b is 7. So in this case, the pair 2, 9 does not belong to S. Okay. So for A there are 25 possibilities, B there are 25 possibilities. So we cannot write all the pairs and select for which the pairs A minus B is equal to 5, this condition is true. So here again we use combinatorics, which gives the answer that how to find number of elements in S. Our aim is to find this. What is mod of S? What is mod of S? Okay. As order is not important here, let us assume, without loss of any generality, assume that A is less than or equal to B. Order is not important. See, whether you write 3, 4 or 4, 3 in a set, it is the same set. So this will not consider as two different pairs. It is the same pair. Okay. Now, if I assume A is less than or equal to B, then mod of A minus B, that is, that will be B minus A is equal to B minus A, because A is less than B, you know, by definition of absolute value, it is minus of A minus B, that is B minus A in this case, because it is always non-negative. And this is equal to what? 5. We want that B minus A is equal to 5 to this condition. And our aim is to find this thing. S is equal to set of all pairs A comma B where A is less than or equal to B and B minus A is equal to 5. That is, we can also say that B is equal to A plus 5. So this is our main set. Okay. Now you see that what is A here? A and B both are elements of X. That is also important thing. A and B both belong to X. Since A belongs to X, how many possibilities are there? 1 to 25. So let us concentrate on that thing. Here, 1 is less than or equal to A is less than or equal to 25. Means A is an integer between 1 to 25. A should be taken from X. If 1 is less than or equal to A is less than or equal to 25, I want to see, okay, what is the condition on B. See, one thing is very clear. This has only one degree of freedom. That means if only one element is selected arbitrarily from this set, then second is fixed. Suppose if I take A is equal to 3, then B will be fixed. That is 5 plus 3 is 8. So B has only one possibility for each choice of A. Let us see what happens to the range of A. Here A lies between 1 to 25. Now I am adding 5 in this inequality. So I will get 6 less than or equal to A plus 5 less than or equal to 30. Okay. But what is A plus 5? What is A plus 5? It is B. As you know here, B is equal to A plus 5. So remember this also is an important formula. 6, we get 6 less than or equal to B, less than or equal to 30. So this says if A is between 1 to 25, then B is between 6 to 30. But as A and B both are in X, they must lie between 1 to 25. So this 30 is not possible. So we can restrict and write 6 less than or equal to B less than or equal to 25. This B cannot exceed 25. So upper limit should be corrected and it should be 25. So whenever 1 less than A less than 25, then B lies between 6 to 25. But what is B? B is A plus 5 again. So I am writing the value of A, B is equal to A plus 5 here. And if this is the case, then if I subtract 5 from this inequality, I will get 1 less than or equal to A, less than or equal to 20. Correct? So I have used the two conditions. If you notice, if A is between 1 to 25, then B is between 6 to 25. And if B is between 6 to 25, then A is between 1 to 20. So this concludes the number of ways in which you can select A so that difference mod A minus B is equal to 5 is 20. You can select any integer from 1 to 20 in place of this A. Okay. So if I select any one of this, then for each of this selection, B is fixed. That is B is equal to A plus 5. So how many elements are there in the set S? So number of elements in the set S are nothing but 20. Because see, for every possibility for A, B is fixed. So B has only one choice. So how many total pairs you can form? Only 20 pairs you can form. As many as A you can select here. So this is the answer of our first question. But this still we can generalize. And not only for 5, for any element I want to think and discuss that what will be the general situation here. You understand the first answer is completed, mod of A minus B is equal to 5, answer is mod S is equal to 20. Let us consider the difference between two numbers is K. If mod of A minus B is equal to say K, where K is some integer, okay, and in this case I can say B minus A is equal to K because we assume that A is always less than or equal to B in order to avoid the duplication. So B minus A is equal to K, and that gives you B is equal to A plus K. B is equal to A plus K. Okay. So if mod of A minus B is equal to K, when the difference between two integers is K, then I define a new set EK which says set of all pairs A comma B where A and B belongs to X, B is equal to A plus K. Okay, that means B minus A is equal to K. If I define this set, then I want to find what is mod of EK. What is mod of EK? Because this discussion, this general discussion for difference of A minus B is equal to K will help us to solve our the next problems. So let us consider EK is equal to set of all pairs A comma B where AB belongs to X, means AB can be any of this 1 to 25 such that B is equal to A plus K. So same technique I am applying here. Since A belongs to X, we have 1 less than or equal to A less than or equal to 25. Now adding K, because I want B here, so adding K in this inequality, I will get 1 plus K less than or equal to A plus K less than or equal to 25 plus K. And this implies I get 1 plus K less than or equal to B, because A plus K is B, is less than or equal to 25 plus K. But as you know, this number 25 plus K, and what is K actually? It is this difference, and K is always greater than or equal to 0. So this is a non-negative integer. Why? Because A and B both are in X and it is set of these integers. So this difference is also an integer, and since it is absolute difference, the K is non-negative integer. So 25 plus something non-negative is greater than or equal to 25. But our set contains only 1 to 25. And this B belongs to X. So this 25 plus K is not possible. So one has to again restrict the upper limit and write up to 25. Okay. So B lies between 1 plus K to 25. Now let us substitute the value of B here. What was B? A plus K. So I get 1 plus K less than or equal to A plus K less than or equal to 25. So this gives us 1 less than or equal to A less than or equal to 25 minus K. 25 minus K. So this is an important thing. What does this suggest? If mod of A minus B is equal to K, and if you define a set EK as this set of all order pairs AB for which B is equal to A plus K, that is difference AB is equal to K, then A can be chosen in how many ways? 1, 2, 3 up to 25 minus K ways. So A has 25 minus K choices. A has 25 minus K choices. And for each choice of A, this B is fixed. For each choice of K, this B is fixed. And it has only one possibility. Suppose if I choose A is equal to, say, 2, then K is equal to 2, then B is equal to A plus K. That is also fixed. And therefore, how many elements will be there in the set EK? EK has 25 minus K elements. So this we have obtained as a formula. If mod of A minus B is equal to K and EK is a set defined like this, then number of elements in EK is 25 minus K. So I am rewriting that thing here. If A minus B is equal to K and EK is equal to set of all pairs such that mod of means AB belongs to X and mod of A minus B is equal to K, then mod of EK is equal to 25 minus K. Mod of EK is equal to 25 minus K. So keeping in mind this formula, we'll think of the second problem. You can see on your screen the second part of this problem, this slide. Mod of A minus B is less than or equal to 5. So now my set S has this condition, mod of A minus B is less than or equal to 5. Mod of A minus B is less than or equal to 5. Okay. If mod of A minus B is equal to K, then we have K is less than or equal to 5. K is less than or equal to 5. Remember, what is K? K is an integer because it is the difference of these two integers. And it is also non-negative integer. That is 0 less than or equal to K less than or equal to 5. Because K is non-negative. So K has these 5 possibilities. So this suggests that this S can be written as a union of this type of sets EK, which I have defined here. You can see EK is equal to set of all AB so that A minus B is equal to K. In short, I can say if I want the difference mod of A minus B to be less than or equal to 5, then I can collect all these sets. So difference is 0 or difference is 1, difference is 2, 3, 4 or 5. So this you can write as union EI, I is equal to 1 to what? 5. S is equal to this thing. So what is mod S? So mod S is equal to sigma mod of EI, I is equal to 1 to, sorry, 0 to 5. 0 to 5. I is equal to 0 to 5. And we have already obtained the formula for mod of EI. Because what was EI? EI is this. EI is this. The difference between A and B is I here in place of K. So mod of EI is 25 minus I. So this is equal to sigma I is equal to 0 to 5. 25 minus I. So just you have to compute this simple sigma notation, sigma value. This can be done by this. Sigma 25 minus sigma I. I is equal to 0 to 5. And here it is also I is equal to 0 to 5. So this will be 25 into 6. 0 to 5, there are 6 numbers. So 6 times you have to repeat this. Minus sigma I 0 to 5 is same as sigma I is equal to 1 to 5 I. Because
1 to 6.
1 to 5. Why 6?
I is 0 to 5, you
say. No, no. Because sigma no. I is sigma 0, sorry, 0 plus 1 plus 2 plus, so we can omit 0 and start the sum with 1, 1 to 5. So it is 25 into 6 minus that formula, 5 into what?
6
by 2, n into n plus 1 by 2. So you can compute this, whatever answer comes. So that will give you the number of elements in S when mod of A minus B is less than or equal to 5. If it is strictly less than sign, that is our third question. Our third question is this. Okay, if S is equal to mod, a set of all AB, so that A minus B is strictly less than 5, then we have strict inequality here. And therefore, strict inequality here also. So, K is equal to what? This set will not be there now. So, K is equal to 0 to 4. Just everywhere you have to change 5 to 4 and you will get the answer for the second question. Now, let us go to the fourth question. You can see on your screen, question number 4. Mod of A minus B is strictly greater than 5. Okay, so I have to just reverse this inequality, but it will not be same. One has to think differently. See, if mod of A minus B is equal to K, then according to this condition, K is greater than 5. K is greater than 5. So, K can be 6, 7, 8, 9 and so on. But as this A and B, as A and B both belongs to X, what can be maximum value of K? What can be maximum value of K? See, the maximum value of K you can understand this way.